Okay, we will start. Before that, I just wanted to clarify one thing, because after asking Viva, I felt many of you have misunderstood one particular concept. For recursive descent parser, also first and follow set symbols are required. Okay, so please go through the algorithm. Without having the first set symbols and follow set symbols, we will not be able to decide on how to proceed the parsing. Okay, even though we write recursive procedures for the non-terminals, but that is not sufficient. Definitely a decision have to be taken, like how to proceed. Okay, so definitely the first set symbols, and if the first set contains epsilon, follow set symbols are also required. Okay, so this is what I wanted to clarify, because when I asked this question, except for three or four students, all of you told, most of you told, it is not required. Okay, it is required only for LL of one USA. So it is not so. It is required for recursive descent parser also. Okay. Anyway, remaining things we'll discuss later. If you have any doubts, maybe I can clarify later.
Ma'am, one more thing to add on.
Yeah, please.
Similarly, for recursive descent parsing, removal of left recursion as well as left factoring is also required.
Yes.
That many were not answering.
Yes, Shriba, thank you. Even when I asked, I think one or two answered like this. Yeah, it is not required. It is not compulsory. They would say, no, for top-down parsing, any top-down parsing, left recursion removal and left factoring is must. It is mandatory to do that. Otherwise, you'll not be able to continue with the parsing. It is as good as you are taking your ambiguous grammar and then going ahead. Okay. And one more thing I want to clarify. Any ambiguous grammar you take and any parsing technique you apply, it won't be successful because the grammar itself is bad. Okay, so it will never be successful. Only thing is you are trying out, that's it. Okay, you have to remove ambiguity and well-defined grammar only you have to use it. So in top-down parsing, we make it compulsory some steps and we do that and then continue. For bottom-up, some steps are not required, but ambiguous grammar here also, it will have its own effect. Okay, so that's what we wanted to clarify. Okay, now I think I can continue with my topics where I had stopped. Again, to recall, students, we were discussing about the bottom-up parsing. In the bottom-up parsing, we start from the leaves and we go towards the root. We construct the tree, and the result of the parsing step is we get the parse tree, and that we trace it and show it in the form of using the data structure. We show it how it passes, whether it is successful or we get error, anything like that we see. Okay, and all kind of syntax errors will be definitely identified in the parsing step. Okay, this will be a common practical question. Whenever there is some error with respect to the syntax, all those errors will be found in the parsing step only. Okay, and among the bottom up parses, we have already completed LR of 0, where we don't use any look ahead symbol. And we have also completed SLR, where we use the follow set symbol to decide on the reduce action. And the next thing was LR of 1, where we use one look ahead symbol, and also we maintain the look ahead symbol in the state itself. Okay, and the last one is LALR of 1, which is obtained after merging the states of LR of 1 state diagram. Okay, again, if you see the hierarchy, LR of 0 is a very weak technique, then comes SLR, then comes LR of 1 and LALR of 1. But among LR of 1 and LALR of 1 also, there is some strategy definitely. So that I'm going to show it today. So between LR of 1 and LALR of 1, which is strong, we can prove using some example. I will show it using example. Okay. And again, coming to the items, what we are going to use, LR of 0 items are used in LR of 0 parsing as well as SLR. And the same LR of zero diagram can be used for LR of zero and SLR parsing. Whereas for LR of one and LLR of one, we will be using LR of one item, where we track the look ahead symbols in the state itself. Okay, so that is the difference, basic difference I have told, because I think you have forgotten about bottom up parsing. So I had to tell. And also, you should be strong in finding the first and follow sets. Few students could not give the correct answer for first and follow sets. So you can't do it blindly. So you have to work out these examples. And then there are variety. If I make small change also, it will have a twist. Okay, so you have to understand all the rules, and then you have to apply, and then you have to get the answer. So as you work more, you get the speed, and also you'll be able to answer. And if the first and follow set is wrong, everything will go wrong. And if your first state in your diagram is wrong, then everything goes wrong. So that is the seriousness you should have when you are drawing the bottom-up parses especially, okay? Yes, now I will proceed with the examples. So we were here with this example. So we wanted to see whether any conflict occurs after merging in the LR of one and to make it LALR of one. So this is the grammar we have taken. And using this grammar, we'll see how we can obtain the different states first in LR of one state diagram, and then we will try to merge and make it LALR of one state diagram. Okay, so to start with, we are going to again start with the first rule. And one more thing, augmentation is nothing but you're going to introduce one new rule where you're going to have something like this. In this particular grammar, the new rule introduced is what? S dash gives S dollar. I think here also you have misunderstood. You are telling labeling is augmentation. No, labeling is just for your convenience, you are doing the labeling. Augmentation is to know when you are going to stop your process. So for that, you need one extra rule for your grammar. Sometimes it will be augmented grammar, sometimes it won't be augmented. So, but you have to do the augmentation so that you know when you're going to stop, okay? Because this is the first rule we are going to start with in the state diagram. Therefore, this is what is known as augmentation. Augmentation is required in the parsing so that you know when the parsing will stop, okay? So we are going to start with that rule only first. And after listing it, you get dot S. Because dot S is there, you're going to expand all the rules with respect to S. And also because it is LR of one parsing, what you have to do is you have to find the look ahead symbol. And when you are finding the look ahead symbol, so here what we did is we just expanded S. After S, whatever comes, so that only you're going to take to find the first. Okay. Even though indirectly you are seeing what is the follow of this S, but the procedure we use is what? After this S, which I have expanded, whatever comes, you're going to take the first of that substring. Okay, so this substring is what we have only dollar here because it is the first rule and we don't have anything and we don't have any look ahead symbol also. So we are going to take dollar only here, and therefore for all these expanded rules, you will get dollar. Okay, so that is the first state. Then coming to the next state is you are going to read S. So wherever S is there, like in all the rules, you are going to see in the RHS. And after reading S, what happens? Dot is moved and you will have only dollar symbol to be read. And that's it. That is the end of this path. It will go to the accept state. And then coming to the next is what we can read A, small a. When you read, there are two rules with the small a. So once you read A, dot operator is moved after small a, and then you get dot capital A. Okay, that is one thing. And the other thing is what? Another rule also, we have small a to be read, and after reading small a, you get dot BE. And notice that whatever look ahead symbol we had, we have just copied the same thing here for both the rules. S gives A dot capital AD, as well as S gives a small a dot BE. Also, we have copied the same look ahead symbol. Now that is done, but we are not done with the state. Why? Because we have the dot operator before the non-terminal. Therefore, we will have to expand this A, and also we have to expand this B. So first we'll see how to expand A. So A is having only one rule, that is rule number 5. So A gives dot C. Okay, after expanding, you have to find the look ahead symbol for this particular rule. So where did you expand? You got this expansion because of this. So after this, what do I have? I have D, and the look ahead symbol is dollar. So what we are going to do is we are going to find first of D followed by dollar. That is, you're going to find first of D dollar. First of D dollar is what? Small d. So that's why this small d exists here. Similarly, because of this dot B, you're going to expand B, and B gives dot C from the rule number 6. And now again, for this rule also, we have to find the look ahead symbol. So after B, what do we have? We have a small e, and the look ahead is a dollar. So you'll be finding first of E dollar, which means that it is E. So that's how the state I2 exists. And nothing else to be done in this state. If at all, if it is, once again, if you get dot some non-terminal, you have to expand more. Anyway, in this state, that's all. So we are going to finish that state and go to the next step is we are going to read small b. When we read small b, there are two rules with small b. So you get b small b dot capital BD, and the same look ahead symbol has been copied from I0. Similarly, S gives B dot capital A small e. Here also dollar is copied as it is. Okay, now we have to expand B. So B is B gives dot C. And after this, we have D dollar. So first of D dollar is D. And similarly for A, we have A gives dot C. And for A, you have expanded from here. Therefore, first of E dollar is E. Okay, students, at this stage, I want you to think for a minute, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me, okay? So how this D came, how this E came, you should understand very well. Then only you will be able to proceed, because this look ahead symbols, it will make a lot of difference, and the number of states also will be more due to this, okay, in LR of 1. So if you want to have, if you want to get any clarification to be done at this stage, you can ask me. Otherwise, I'll proceed with the next state. Any doubts, don't think that it is silly doubt. Just ask, because if you don't understand this first two examples, then all other examples also will be more complex for you. So complexity increases. Therefore, at this stage, if you have any doubts, you can ask me so that I can clarify and then continue.
Ma'am, in rule number 4, is it BAE or BAC? Because in I0 it is C, and in rules it is E.
This one? In I0 is it?
Yes, ma'am.
I0?
Last rule, dot BAE or BAC?
It is BAE only. I purposely took E because otherwise it is a confusion with this C also. Okay? It is E only.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, it is E. Yeah. Okay, students, I will continue then if you don't have any doubts. So I1, I2, I3, we have finished. Then we'll proceed, and always you follow some systematic way of doing it so that you don't forget any path. Okay, see how I am doing. Maybe you can I am doing very systematically. Maybe you can also follow that so that you don't forget any rule, any state. Okay. Now I will, anyway, we have completed because there is nothing to do much. Dollar only we have to read, and it will go to accept. So let us read capital A now at state I2. When you read A, what happens? Dot will be moved, and the same dollar symbol is copied. And after moving the dot, there is nothing to expand, because after dot, we have terminal symbol. So there is nothing to do. So that's it in I4. And coming to I5, we are going to read capital B. And after reading the capital B, the dot is moved. That's it. And again, here also, we don't have anything to expand. So it's just the transition. That's it. And that is I5. And then coming to reading C, when we read C, what happens? The dot is moved, and we have two rules with C to be read in this state I2. Therefore, after reading, the dot is moved, and if you notice, we have only one locate symbol for each of these rules, that is D and E. Same thing has been copied, and there is nothing much to do here. And if you notice here, this is eligible for reduce action now, because the dot operator is present in the rightmost position for both the rules, that is rule corresponding to capital A and rule corresponding to capital B. Okay, so that is I6. I6 is done, and then coming to at I3, when we read capital B, it generates this I7. Here also nothing much to do. You have to just move the dot operator and everything is copied as it is, and we don't have anything to expand. Similarly, I8 also, when you read capital A, you get this, and then same thing here also. And when you read C, you'll get something like this. Maybe you will feel that I6 and I9 are similar, but if you see the look ahead symbols for B rule, the look ahead symbol in I6 is E, and whereas in I9 it is D. And similarly for A rule, the look ahead symbol is D at I6 and it is E at I9. Therefore, these are different states. Okay. In LR of 1, we will take it as different states, but in LLR of 1, you can combine. Okay. So I6 and I9 are different, and we have got this I9. And in I3, we have finished all the transitions. So that is done. And coming to at I4, if you read, that is only one possibility that you are going to read D. And after reading D, the dot is moved towards the rightmost position, and that is done. So this path is completed, which is I10. And we will go ahead with the next step. That is at I5 also, when you read E, this is this particular state also will be completed. This path is completed. So dot is in the rightmost position. That is the end. And already I6 is completed. Coming to I7, when you read D, you'll get this state. And similarly, when you read E at I8, you'll get I13. And I9 is already completed. So now you verify whether all the paths have been completed or not. If it is done, then your diagram is ready. Okay, so that's it. In all the paths we have completed. So this is what we have got as LR of one state diagram. And what is LR of one item is you have the rule and you have the dot operator in the right hand side. And also you maintain the look ahead symbol in the state itself. So that is LR of one item. So this is the state diagram of LR of one. Now we will proceed with the parsing table. We will construct the parsing table using this diagram. The same diagram has been copied. I will do it online now. You have to help me. Okay. Yes, this is the parsing table for LR of 1. First, we'll construct the parsing table for LR of 1, and then we will try to do it for LLR of 1. Okay, so at state number 0, yes, all of you should concentrate, because whatever examples I take, if you are involved only, you'll learn. Otherwise, it's difficult. So at state I0, when you read S, it goes to 1. Okay. At state I naught, when you read small a, it is shift to 2. And then at state I naught, when you read b, it is shift 3. I will make mistakes, students. You have to identify in between. Otherwise, I have to see whether you are alert or not. Okay, so these are the three transitions that is done in I naught. And coming to state number 1, we don't have anything, because this is the only rule we have got in I1. Therefore, that is supposed to be the accept as usual. And coming to state number 2, at state number 2, when you read capital A, it is go to 4. Okay, at state number 2, on capital B, it is go to 5. Okay. And remember that this is a table and you are maintaining two things. One is the action part and the other one is the go-to part. And in the go-to, we have all the non-terminals. And for the action part, we have all the terminal symbols, including the dollar symbol. Okay. And across the rows, we maintain all our states. Okay. So I2, we have done with A and B. And if you read C, what happens? When you read C, it is shift 6. Is it correct?
Ma'am, in the below row, you should keep.
Yes, very good. That's why. So you're alert. Okay, so S6. At 3 on capital B, it is go to 7. Go to 7. And at 3 on capital A, please mute others, please mute. Those who are answering only should unmute and speak and then again mute. So 8 and then on small C it is yes 9. Please mute. Students, please mute whoever it is. At 4. At 4 on small d, it is yes 10. Okay, yes 10. And at, that's all. At 5 on small e, it is yes 11. At 6, what do you see? At 6, we don't have any shift operation. If you notice, it is only the reduce operation. And the reduce operation is what? You have to see the rule number and on what symbol. So anyway, we have already maintained the look ahead symbol here. So the rule number 5, that is A gives C, that rule we have to use for reduce action on what symbol? On D. So on D, it is rule number 5. And on E, it is rule number 6. Okay, so that is done. Coming to state number 7 on D, it is yes 12. Yes 12. And at 8 on small e, it is yes 13. And then coming to state number 9, is again the reduce action. On D, we should have rule number. What rule number?
6.
Rule number 6. Yes. Rule number 6. And on E, it is rule number 5. Okay. So at 10, it is the reduce action because that is the end of the path. So at 10, rule number what? Rule number A, small a, capital A, D is rule number 1. And on what symbol? It is on the dollar symbol. So rule number 1 on dollar symbol at 10. At 11 on dollar rule number 3. Is it rule number 3, students?
Ashanti, can you mute yourself? Yashwant.
Now Yashwant only should answer the next question. Busy in something, right? Okay, at 12 on dollar, it is rule number 2. Rule number 2. And at 13 on dollar, it is rule number 4. So this is what we got as our parsing table. Okay, so this is what we have got as a parsing table. This table I will copy later and we will try to trace it. So, okay, students, at this stage, do you see any conflicts for this particular table? Of course, you can find the conflict in the diagram also, we don't see any conflict here. Do we have any conflict? Either the shift reduce conflict or the reduce conflict. So you have to recall what is shift reduce conflict. Whenever you have confusion between the shift operation and the reduce operation, we say it is a shift reduce conflict. And whenever we have the conflict between two different rules for reduce action, then we say it is reduce conflict. Okay. So in this particular table, we don't have any two entries like that. One is shift and the other one is reduce, or two rules for reduce action. We don't have something like that. Okay. So there are no conflicts in this particular table. Therefore, whatever grammar we have used, it is well suitable for the LR of one parsing. There is no issue and there is no conflict also. So you can conclude that this particular grammar is. Yes, please mute the students. Grammar is.
Ashwant, are you there? I don't think Ashwant is in place.
Shriba, you remove him from the meeting. That's better, I think. If they're not listening, why to be in the meeting, right? Remove him, let him report to me to us later. Okay, this grammar is suitable for LR of one. So that is the conclusion we have. This grammar is LR of one. Okay, so that is the conclusion. We will proceed with the next thing is what we have, this LR of one state diagram which we constructed just now.
Ma'am, you can only show him, ma'am.
Okay, I'll do that then. Okay, this is the diagram for LR of one state diagram, which we constructed just now. And then you see now what are the states that can be combined to construct in LR of one. Okay, students, at this stage, your answer is seen, but still I want you to think and answer. So which all states are similar and they differ only in the look ahead symbols you can see. So which are the states?
I6, I9.
Okay. I6, I9, it is there. Any other state is there like that which can be merged? Yes or no? Students, yes or no, only I6 and I9 can be merged, that's all? Are you convinced?
Ma'am,
with
I6
that?
And I9 can also not be merged, ma'am. The follow sets are different, right?
That's what I told. No, in LR of one, how do we merge? We can merge only. See, in LR of one, I can't merge. Okay, in LR of one, I can merge. So, what we have done, we have constructed LR of one. So, what is LR of one? In LR of one, we can merge all the states that has the same items, but only they differ in the look ahead symbols. That's what the LR of one says. Okay. So now in LR of one, I can't merge. Okay. Only in LR of one, we can merge. So we have already constructed LR of one diagram. From here, we find what all can be merged, and then we will merge it like this. Okay. So what is that we merged? We merged 6 and 9. So this state merging happens only in LR of one, not in LR of one. LR of one will be, it will take properly all the look ahead symbols and the contents of the state also. You cannot merge in the LR of one, but you can merge in LR of one state diagram. So what is that we did? First state remains the same. All this remains the same. So where does it affect then? Here it affects. Okay, on C, instead of taking only DE as the locate symbol like before, we can merge both and we can take that. Okay, so that's the only difference. And because of this, already this state is constructed, and at state I3 on C, when you read, it will go to the same I69. So I have merged both state 6 and 9 into 1, and also locate symbols also we have listed. Means you have found the union of the locate symbols, and rest all remains the same. Rest all remains the same. Okay, now what we can do is, I will copy this table. From this table, we can construct the LLR of 1 also. So LLR of 1 parsing table we know. Now from this, what changes will happen to LLR of 1? What are the changes we are going to have, students? I will make changes here only, because anyway that is constructed. So small changes only we need to do. No, what all changes we have to do? So it is merged, right? 6 and 9 has been merged. So when I'm shifting here, it becomes 6, 9, and at 3 also it becomes 6, 9, and then this 6 and 9 is merged. So what happens in 9, whatever occurs, that also I need to list here. So what happens, R5 is already there. I also put R6, if you notice. Here also R6 is already there. I need to put R5. Okay. Now this does not exist. This does not exist. I will remove it. Okay. So this does not exist, because I have already merged. Okay, that I'll remove later. Now we have what? This is called 6, 9 instead of 6. Okay, 9 has been removed. Rest all is same. Everything is same. Only these merging happens. After merging, if you notice, what happens in the state 6, 9, if you notice, this is having the conflict. Okay, so this is having the conflict. Therefore, after merging, we have the conflict. Before merging, there was no conflict. Means it is suitable for LR of 1, but it is not suitable for LLR of 1. Why? Because we are having conflict at state number 6, 9. At state number 6, 9, if you go here, see on D also, we can apply A gives C, on E also we can apply similarly. B gives C also, we can apply on D as well as E. Due to that nature, in the diagram only you can identify easily. There is a reduced conflict. So when you have the input symbol, say D red, and after that dot appears, now it is eligible for reduce, and there are two rules with the same situation, either R5 or R6. Okay, so that is what we have to see. Now let us take this example and parse it. So LR of 1, anyway, it is suitable, so you can definitely parse it. So LLR of 1, I can conclude that it is not suitable. It is not LALR of 1 because of reduce conflict. So that is the conclusion we can have from this table. Now let us see how it can be parsed using the stack. So you would have forgotten now, because after learning top down parsing for T1, you would have forgotten bottom up. So let us take this example to parse. So first is what, I have taken this string BCD. At 0, we will start with $0, because that is the initial state. So $0, we have taken BCD. At 0 on B is a shift to, it is nothing but shift 3, isn't it? So how do we do that? We have dollar zero. We shift that symbol first, and then we shift the state number also. Now in the input buffer, we have only CD dollar. This is small c. And now add three on C, it is shift 69. We are going to once again shift 0, B, 3, small c we are going to shift, and we are going to use the state number say 69. And now in my input buffer, I have only D dollar. And then now at 69 on D, at 69 on D, we have what? Reduce conflict. Because there is a conflict, which one to apply now is a problem. Okay, means whether I should go with rule number 5 or rule number 6, that is what is known as the reduce conflict. Okay, and how to resolve, the tool will definitely resolve. At this stage only I will tell. If at all you want to continue, then you have to give some strategy and then continue. Okay, usually what happens in the tools, what we use, like if at all you use Yak or Bison, so what it does is it will give the priority for the first come first serve. Means whichever rule occurs first, that rule it will take. Means according to this, rule number 5 will occur first than the rule number 6, so it will override and use this A gives C, that rule only it will give, it will take, it will not take B gives C. Okay, so therefore it will continue. If it has to continue, what it will do is it will override and take rule number 5 because that is occurring first. So if you take rule number 5, what happens? I will continue by resolving, that is known as the conflict resolving, and then continuing 0, B, 3, C, 6, 9 was there. Anyway, we are reducing it, right? Rule 5 means I'm going to remove the state number first, then I'm going to remove that symbol. And what is that rule? I have to replace that C with capital A, that is the non-terminal in the LHS. So now I have got A, and then at three on A is what? State number 8. So you have found the next state also. Then we get D dollar, which is still there. We didn't shift it. So at eight on D is what? I don't have any rule. This is supposed to be error because it is a blank entry. It is a blank entry, therefore it is an error. Suppose if it was an accepting string, after overriding, after using some strategy, after resolving, maybe you could have achieved like successful parsing. But this particular string is not generated at all in the given grammar. Therefore, even after resolving the conflict, you are not able to get the successful parsing. Okay, so that's how it works. You take another example and maybe you can try the accepted string. You can also try on LR of one, anyway it is a good grammar, so no problem. We can leave that. So but LLR of one you try because it is having the conflict. Wherever D occurs, no, at some point it will have the problem. And if you want to resolve, we are going to use the first come first. So whichever rule occurs first, so that rule will be taken into account, and using that only we are going to perform reduce action and then continue. So after continuing, if at all the string is generated from the given grammar, then it has to successfully parse it. If it is not generated, then it would say that it is an error. Okay. So I think I have given this is a very good example because it is having the reduce conflict. Till now, whatever examples we have taken, we have not encountered reduce conflict. So by this, you can conclude that whenever you try to merge the states in the LALR of one, when you merge and the look ahead symbols also will be taken together, so at that time, there is a possibility of getting the reduce conflict. So mostly it is like that. Okay, so this is a very good example which can explain the reduce-reduce conflict. And now you can see the strength you can compare. So the grammar which is LR of 1 is not LLR of 1. Okay, so the same grammar I took it and I did LR of 1. But after merging, you are getting the conflict. So the strength, if you say now, the strength is good in LR of 1 only. Okay. So what are the advantages and disadvantages then? In LR of 1, the problem is it will create lot of states, because for each look ahead symbol, for each production rule, you have to see and construct the state, and therefore it grows like anything. The number of states grows like anything. Whereas to overcome that only, we tried using the LLR of 1, where at least the states which has the difference in the look ahead symbols, we try to merge it. Okay, we can merge, not a problem. Only thing is that in some grammars, after merging, there is a chance of getting the reduce-reduce conflict. Okay, so that's why the strength of LLR of 1 is lesser than the strength of LR of 1. So I would say that LR of 0 is the weakest, and then SLR, where you take one locate symbol into account only for deciding on the reduce action, and then we have LLR of 1 in the hierarchy, and then LR of 1. So LR of 1 is the strongest technique among these four techniques. Okay, among these four techniques, LR of 1 is the strongest. And of course, LR of K would be the strongest, because as you increase the number of locate symbols, it is more convenient for you to decide, and then it works well actually. Okay, some example maybe we can take where it is the grammar is not even LR of 1. So we have seen the strength. If it is not LR of 1, then definitely it won't be LLR of 1, it won't be SLR, it won't be LR of 0. On the other way, if some grammar is LR of 0, then obviously it will be SLR, obviously it will be LR of 1, and also it is LLR of 1. Okay. And some grammars will not be LR of 0, but they will be SLR. So that you need to compare with the higher techniques. Then if the grammar is SLR, then it will be surely LR of 1, and also it will be LLR of 1. Okay, and I'm just concluding all the remarks about these parsing techniques. If some grammar is LR of 1, we cannot say that it is definitely LLR of 1. We can't say that. After merging, there may be a possibility of getting the conflicts. But if some grammar is LALR of 1, then for sure it will be LR of 1. Okay, so these comparisons you should have, then only you'll be able to understand the concept. Because many times you don't write everything, you don't design everything. So once you design LR of 0 and if it is satisfying, then it is definitely suitable for all other parsing techniques also. So you don't have to try, actually it happens. But if it is not LR of 0, then definitely you have to go with the stronger technique and then try out. And then if it is working fine, yes, you can use that. Okay, so that is a hierarchy. Later I'll give the hierarchy, but now I have told the conclusion, the remarks about it. So in the next class, maybe I will take some more examples. So I have taken few examples, which is LR of 0. And I have taken some example where it is not LR of 0, but SLR. I've taken an example which is LR of 1, but not LLR of 1. I've taken an example which is both LR of 1 and LLR of 1. All possibilities have tried, and some more we will try. Okay, some more we will try, and then I would like to give some problems for yourself to try out, and then maybe I will create a link maybe by next week or something. You can all of you can try all the steps in the top down and bottom up parsing, and then you try out, solve it, and then upload. Let me see whether you are going the right path or not. Otherwise, without writing, you will never get the confidence. Okay, by just reading this course, you will not understand. It is just like TOC, where you can't read. It is not a subject where you can just read and understand. No, that's not the way to learn this course. So definitely I want all of you to try out the examples given, and you try yourself, and where you get stuck, you should notice that. Okay, so maybe after finishing all these problems, I will give the questions. You all can try that and upload. Let us see whether you are understanding, whether you're able to solve or not. Again, don't copy. Copying will not help you. because only when you understand, when you encounter the problems, you'll be sure and you'll be confident. So try yourself. If you're not getting answer, it's okay. There is no marks for it. It's only for learning. Okay, so let us continue some more examples in the next class, and then I'll give the hierarchy of all the passing techniques, and we can conclude this particular topic. Okay, so as I say, whenever you do the parsing, whenever you trace using the stack, also you can try writing the derivation tree, that is a parse tree, parallelly, because the visibility is more in that. You can notice, okay, whether this is accepted or rejected. So that habit you should have for all the grammars, and for some sentences at least you should be able to try. Okay, students, with this I will conclude today's class, and if you have any doubts, 2 minutes are there, you can ask me. Any doubts, students?
Ma'am, in real life compilers, is top down parsing used or bottom up parsing is used?
Okay, so anyway, it is a good question. We can go with both the parsing technique, but I would say always the bottom up parsers are the best. Okay, and among the bottom up parsers, you can't say there also recursive descent parser was there. Here also we have LR of 0, which is the weakest one. Okay, so when you want to compare, you know, LL of 1 is always compared with LR of 1. LL of K is compared with LR of K. LL of 1, maybe I can say it is almost equal to LR of 1. Similarly, LL of K is almost equal to LR of K in terms of grammars, in terms of grammars. But if you say the strength and the tools we create is for the bottom up parsers, and we always try to use the bottom up parsers more because the strategy used in selecting the rule and to continue with the parsing itself is good in bottom up parsing. And you know the overhead of removal of left recursion over there and then perform left factoring, all that is there. But here you take any grammar is not a problem. But it should be unambiguous. That's the only constraint we have. Okay, so preferably in the tools, it is bottom up parsing. And if you want to develop yourself, it is your convenience whether you want to go with top down parsing or bottom up parsing. So the users, it is their choice. But for the tools, yes, definitely the bottom up parsers, because all these are table driven, and table driven parsers are supposed to be the good ones because it is very clear. Clarity is there. Once you create the table, you can run any number of times. That's the advantage we get. Okay. Is that the answer for your question?
Yes, ma'am. Thanks, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, students, thank you very much. It's time. You can leave.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.